on today's episode, why fusion is the hottest trend for 2022. Today's episode is brought to you by Engineering.com, a globally trusted source for engineering content. Check out this and many other exclusive videos for the engineering professional found only on Engineering.com TV today. What's the most significant development in engineering in 2021? Now, some look to rocketry in spaceflight, quantum computing, or civil engineering megaprojects, but I think it's where money intersects with environmentalism, and that's nuclear fusion. Now, you know when technology's permeated mainstream consciousness when you see it in Hollywood. In the Michael J. Fox vehicle, Back to the Future, the flying DeLorean was powered by a coffee-maker-sized fusion reactor called Mr. Fusion, fueled by, literally, garbage. Now, fanciful as that may seem, that's essentially the promise of fusion energy. Use little or nothing as fuel and produce vast quantities of clean energy. Now, the search for a system that can actually do this goes back to the 1950s, and since the 1970s, the popular press has talked of how commercial fusion reactors are about 20 years away. Are we still 20 years away? Well, probably, but there's a difference now in that the global investment community is starting to pour capital into fusion ventures that would have never seen NASDAQ, let alone the Dow. Suddenly, fusion is no longer science fiction, but it's attracting real interest from global capital. Now, there are a couple of reasons for this, and not all of them have to do with engineering. We have a cash-saturated market that's hungry for returns, and with asset prices bid sky high, it's getting harder and harder for that money to find a place to work. And although few bets are as risky as commercial fusion development, the potential returns are, of course, spectacular. So what is the value of a company that can produce endless amounts of clean energy in the age of global warming? Between here and there, however, there are more than a few obstacles. There are multiple different technologies under development, from polywell to stellarators, magnetic plasma confinement, laser ignition, and even a novel mechanical system managing shockwaves in liquid metal. Now, magnetic plasma confinement has had decades of development and billions of dollars with mega projects like ITER in France. Some operations, like Lawrenceville Plasma Physics in New Jersey, operate on a shoestring and hope to exploit novel technologies to do an end run around the incredibly large and complex systems needed to confine plasmas or ignite fuel pellets with lasers. General Fusion, a Canadian-based company, is developing a novel mechanical shockwave technology, and it's drawn enough investment interest to begin construction of a test reactor in the UK. Now, to be clear, no one has demonstrated engineering break-even, the point at which the amount of energy out of the system is the same as the energy pumped into the system, plus the energy to operate the equipment. But money is a key metric of confidence, and the amounts of investment now flowing into fusion startups shows a clear expectation of commercial reactors in an investor's timeline, which is generally under a decade. But what if the systems don't work? Now, that likelihood is decreasing every year as supercomputers and advanced simulation are combined with a better understanding of the science of nuclear fusion. There are simply fewer unknowns today by the time engineers sit down to render a reactor. It's the combination of high-performance computing, simulation software, and a large influx of that critical engineering lubricant, money, that I think will take us to that inflection point on the development curve, where by this time next year, one or two clear leaders in the race to commercial fusion technology will emerge. Will it be laser ignition, magnetic confinement, hydraulic rams? Well, it's hard to tell, but once that clear pathway to commercial success is demonstrated, money will not be a problem. And I can't wait to report back next year. Well, that's it for today's episode of End of the Line, brought to you by Engineering.com. If you like this show, be sure to subscribe to our channel and click on the notification bell for our next episode. For our deeper engineering video series for the manufacturing professional, visit Engineering.com TV to watch exclusive shows like Manufacturing the Future, not found here on our YouTube channel. The link is in the description below. Thanks for watching.